Seawall is fighting not only to save its reputation, but also its business. It hired a new CEO this month and launched a new ad campaign to counter what it calls unfair criticism. I'm joined now by Mark Simmons, a former SeaWorld trainer who is the author of Killing Keiko, the true story of Free Willy's return to the wild. Also with us tonight here, John Hargrove, also a former SeaWorld trainer who we saw in Martin Savage's report. He is author of Beneath the Surface. So, gentlemen, thank you both for coming in. John, let me just begin with you. After watching Martin Savage's piece, you said to him, you talked about SeaWorld being this glorified circus, yet you were part of that glorified circus for 14 years. This was a childhood dream of yours. Why'd you leave?
Oh man, it was so hard to leave. I mean, for years I was happy and 100% SeaWorld loyalist and believed in that system. And I left ultimately because you see over time the damaging psychological and physical effects on these whales in captivity. And it's just a process and an evolution that you arrive at, that they are truly hurting being in captivity.
I know that SeaWorld, though, says this. They say that you quit, quote, after being disciplined for a severe safety violation involving the park's killer whales. How do you respond to that?
Well, I protest to that. It is factual that I quit after this event happened, but it was another trainer's mistake. It was not mine. I reported it. Their issue with me reporting it was that I waited to tell management until the next day, but I still came forward with another trainer's mistake. I didn't agree with the disciplinary action, so that is true, and that is, you know, I protested it formally. But I left on medical disability because of my right knee from years of swimming with the whale injuries.
Okay. You too worked at SeaWorld. You were in Blackfish, though now you say that documentary does go too far. Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, Brooke, I was interviewed by Gabriella for 3 hours. And, you know, she used 1 minute of what I talked about, which was congruent with the agenda of the film. I talked about, I was Telecom's team leader for 3 years. I brought Telecom from Victoria to SeaWorld. I had more experience than all the other trainers that talked about this situation put together with this animal, and I explained what happened. It didn't make it, it didn't fit with the agenda of the film, so it wasn't used. So, yeah, that's my beef, is that, you know, this is not a true representation of that situation. And quite frankly, what we're talking about is the sensationalism of this one event, this one outlier that was not a SeaWorld whale. It was not raised in the SeaWorld system.
But why participate in the film then?
Well, because I didn't want to participate in the film originally. I mean, it took 2 days to convince me to participate in the film. I didn't trust the agenda of the filmmaker, but I felt like it was better to at least have a voice than sit by and do nothing.
Okay. John, part of the news here, 3 lawsuits have been filed against SeaWorld, saying ticket holders were misled that when they were told that these captive killer whales were happy and healthy. And so in a statement, SeaWorld says, in part, the lawsuit appears to be an intent by animal rights extremists to use the courts to advance its anti-zoo agenda. The suit is baseless, filled with inaccuracies, and SeaWorld intends to defend itself against these inaccurate claims. You know, that's their position. We know, though, from all kinds of reaction from Blackfish, you know, it wasn't just the animal rights extremists who were pounding their fists on the table.
Right, and I think it's important to note when people say anybody who comes out as an outspoken critic of SeaWorld is immediately labeled as an animal rights extremist. Now they label me that way. And I'm definitely not an animal rights extremist, but that's the way they label anyone who attacks their business practices.
I have to stay with you because we have to talk about this video.
Yes.
We have to talk about this video. SeaWorld emailed us a video that's already circulating online of you using the N-word multiple times. They say it came from an internal whistleblower. Here's a part of it.
Do you think that that was risky to whip around and say those 5 Did you think that that was risky?
And then SeaWorld told us this in an email, quote, we are offended by John's behavior and language. The video is particularly reprehensible since John Hargrove is wearing a SeaWorld shirt. SeaWorld would have terminated Hargrove's employment immediately had we known he engaged in this kind of behavior. And I mean, John, we showed part of the video. It goes on. You continue your use of the N-word multiple times.
For 5 minutes.
Can you explain yourself?
Well, I mean, it's, I agree with part of the SeaWorld statement. It is, you know, indefensible. I mean, it hurt to watch it because you know that saying that word hurts people.
What was that about?
Well, I was had a person on the speakerphone, and I'm trying to get them to relay a story. And in the story are the racial slurs. And we were clearly heavily intoxicated. We were not in our right frame of mind. It was 5 years ago. I regret it. I'm all for you take full responsibility for your actions. You apologize because, and I did right away, because I don't want to hurt anybody. But that is not an accurate, that 5 minute snapshot of me completely intoxicated using horrible judgment from 5 years ago does not represent who I am today or take away from my experience and what I achieved with my career at SeaWorld and what I'm trying to educate people about what really happens with these whales.
What about what really happens, Mark, and also the fact we also saw in Martin's piece how he's pointing out SeaWorld is planning on increasing their facilities for these kinds of whales in these parks just to give them more space, but I have to imagine that's a direct response to all of this.
Well, Brooke, you know, it certainly seems that way. I mean, we've been talking about bigger pools since I was there, which was 20 years ago. I left in 1996.
But that's talk now. This is action.
It is talk. It is now action. And sure, that could be related. It's hard not to see that. But it's still a good thing. It's still a very good thing. You know, I disagree with this entire... This is a perversion of reality, what we're talking about here, what Mr. Hargrove wants
to
sell.
What's a perversion?
I have lived this life. This has been my life as well. I met my wife at SeaWorld, and she had 14 years there, supervisor of Family Stadium. I'd been 12 years consecutive with killer whales in the water, thousands upon thousands of in-water interactions. Not one single incident between our collective 26 years, between the two of us. This is not the life that I led. This is not the life that I saw. And these animals are not nameless, faceless beasts. They have personalities. They have learning histories. There's Keith now out in San Diego who's a goofball, and Corky who's taught more trainers than trainers have taught her. And this gets lost in the mix. But this is not the life. I can't reconcile with this. This is not what happens there.
Mark Simmons and John Hargrove, we have to leave it there, but thank you both for coming on and sharing your differing opinions on the whole thing. I really appreciate both of you tonight. Now, to a pair of visionaries doing what it takes to make their dream a reality, they want to be